call to order the Thursday, March 28th, 2019 regular meeting of the Union County Board of Chosen Freeholders. And Clerk of the Board, please call the roll.
Freeholder Estrada.
Present.
Freeholder Garrettson.
Here.
Freeholder Granados.
Here.
Freeholder Hudak.
Present.
Freeholder Palmieri Mudet.
Here.
Freeholder Staton.
Here.
Freeholder Williams.
Here.
Vice Chair Mirabella.
Present.
And Chair Kowalski.
Here.
Chair, you have 9 freeholders present.
Thank you. Would you please lead us in the prayer and salute to the flag?
Humbly we ask God, the giver of peace and lover of charity, to give the entire family of nations true agreement with his will, and to grant the light of his spirit on all who work for justice and peace.
Amen. Amen.
Pledge allegiance
to the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Mr. Clerk, would you please read the Statement of Compliance with the Open Public Meetings Act?
The Chair wishes to announce that pursuant to the requirements of New Jersey statutes annotated Title 10, Chapter 4, Section 10 of the Open Public Meetings Act, adequate notice of this meeting of the Board of Chosen Freeholders of the County of Union has been given by mailing the annual meeting schedule for the year 2019, along with periodic changes necessitated by circumstances, to the newspapers circulating within the County of Union who are designated to receive such notice, and by posting the annual meeting schedule for the year 2019 in the Administration Building, and further, by filing the annual meeting schedule for the year 2019 with the Office of the County Clerk.
Thank you. May I have a motion to approve communications?
So moved, Madam Chair.
Second, please.
Second.
Second by Freeholder
Hudak.
Hudak.
There's a tie.
Okay. Clerk of the Board, please call the roll.
Freeholder Estrada.
Yes.
Freeholder Garrettson.
Yes.
Freeholder Granados.
Aye.
Freeholder Hudak.
Aye.
Freeholder Palmieri Mudet.
Yes.
Freeholder Staton.
Yes.
Freeholder Williams.
Aye.
Vice Chair Mirabella.
Aye.
And Chair Kowalski.
Yes.
Chair, you have 9 freeholders voting in the affirmative.
Thank you. Before we open up the meeting for public comment, I'd like to ask Fiscal Chairman Mirabella to say a few words about the 2019 budget, which is to be introduced tonight, and that is resolution number 2019-234. Vice Chair Mirabella?
Yes, thank you, Madam Chair. Following the review of the 2019 budget over the past several weeks, we are set for introduction tonight. Since the county manager presented his executive budget to this board in March, the Fiscal Affairs Committee has trimmed the budget by an additional $900,000 without any disruption to services. This budget is below cap. The tax levy has been further reduced to 1.75% increase, which is the lowest, among the lowest in the last 20 years. Tonight, the public is welcome to make comments about the budget during the general comments portion of the meeting. This Freeholder Board will be holding a public hearing on the budget Thursday, April 25th at 7 o'clock, prior to its regular meeting. I'd like to thank the following members of the Fiscal Affairs Committee for their hard work and diligence: Freeholders Estrada, Mudet, and Estrada and Granados, two Estradas.
I was gonna say, and, over here.
I thank him, doubly thank him.
He really contributed.
You need to learn even better.
However, I wanna thank all the Freeholders who participated in the budget hearings that we had. The three of them, one was in Westfield, one was in Kenilworth, and one was right here in Elizabeth. All the Freeholders made their comments known, and their input was taken into consideration by the county manager, and it was a great process. I also want to thank the directors, particularly Director Taylor and her staff for the efforts, and most especially our county manager, Ed Oatman, and our deputy county manager for doing the great job they do every year. So I'm delighted to be in a position to make these comments, to support this budget, and it's good for Union County, and it's good for the services that we offer providing for our residents. Thank you, Madam Chair.
Thank you, Vice Chairman. And now the meeting's open to the public for the purpose of commenting on resolutions being offered for adoption only. And if you would like to comment, please state your name and town of residence for the record. Seeing no one, I'll formally close this portion of the meeting. And we can move on to, oh, sorry. Before we go to freeholder comments, let's adopt the resolutions. May I have a motion to adopt resolutions 2019-214 through 2019-291?
So moved, Madam Chair.
Second.
Okay, thank you. The first motion made by Vice Chair Mirabella and seconded by Freeholder Staten. Would you please call the roll?
Freeholder Estrada?
Yes.
Freeholder Garrettson?
Yes.
Freeholder Granados?
Aye.
Freeholder Hudak?
Mr. Clerk, I'd like to register an abstention on 2019-219. Aye to the rest.
Freeholder Palmieri Mudeg?
Aye.
Freeholder Staten?
Yes.
Freeholder Williams?
Aye.
Vice Chairman Mirabella?
Aye.
And Chair Kowalski?
Yes.
Chair, you have 9 votes in the affirmative with the exception of one resolution, resolution number 2019-219, where you have 8 votes in the affirmative and 1 abstention.
Thank you, Mr. Clerk. And now I'd like to open the meeting to the public for the purpose of commenting on any governmental issue that you would feel may be of concern to the residents of the county. And if you would like to speak, please give us your name and town of residence. Seeing no one, I'll formally close this portion of the meeting, and I would like to mention that we will be amending the Freeholder meeting schedule. The May 9th agenda meeting will now be held on May 2nd, and what was announced as the May 30th double meeting has also been moved up, and that will be held on May 23rd. So May 2nd and May 23rd will be Freeholder meeting nights. And now we will go to Freeholder reports. Freeholder Granados.
Thank you, Chair. Just want to make note of the various organizations that partake in our Adopt the Park. This past weekend, I joined Freeholder Mudeg in Warnenkel Sports Center for an event. But as I was driving through the park, I witnessed the organization volunteering their time in cleaning up our park. And when I passed actually next to them and got a chance to talk to them, it was actually students from King University who were volunteering their time on a weekend to make sure they collected over 30 bags of leaves and various other items that were within our park. So I just want to thank all the organizations that continue to make sure our parks are clean and giving back to our community. Thank you, Chair.
Thank you. Freeholder Williams?
Yes, I have a couple of things. First, I want to mention I attended the sensory-friendly performance of Sleeping Beauty this past weekend, presented by the New Jersey Ballet, and it was fantastic. We had a huge amount of families there. Some people came via bus in groups, and I got a lot of compliments from the attendees, their gratefulness to the county for putting on these particular productions. They said they're really looking forward to seeing a lot more. I know we're at the 1.75 cap, but they really, really enjoyed it, and they really wanted to thank us all for that. In addition, as you know, we're continuing our celebration of Women's History Month, and that will conclude with a special presentation of a play at the Hamilton Stage in Rahway, part of the Union County Performing Arts Center. The presentation of the play called In Their Footsteps, and In Their Footsteps honors 5 American women who served during the Vietnam War, and it uses their own words to tell their stories. One of the 5 women featured in the play is Judy Jenkins Gaudino, whom some of you may know. She's a resident of Summit. This event is free, but seating is limited, so please, you can still reserve a seat online. Just go to ucnj.org/women, and On another note, I want to remind everyone that April 23rd, there'll be a free educational presentation in Scotch Plains titled What Parents Need to Know About Transgender Individuals. And the purpose of this presentation is to help parents and other community members better understand the issues of transgender people and those, and also to help them understand more gender identity, as well as including tips on how to speak to young people and children about these topics. For more information, you can call the county's Karen Positen. She's part of our Human Rights Commission at area code 908-889-9028. That concludes my remarks. Thank you, Chair.
Thank you, Freeholder Williams. Freeholder Hudak?
Thank you, Chair. I want to commend the directors, from the various departments today on our agenda. And I think, what we saw from the Human Services portion, Parks, Director Graziano came up and talked about our road resurfacing budget. It speaks to the priorities of this board and our county government in terms of where we are spending the public's money. We have a robust road resurfacing program at $11 million this year, and we are setting up for a robust program in 2020. We've talked about the parks, and even earlier today, I know we had various committee meetings, and we talked about the opening of the Wheeler Park Spray Park, and that is coming up in Memorial Day. And as I came by that park today and seeing the preparations to lay the final concrete down, I'm very excited. I know the residents of the city of Linden are as well. And as Freeholder Granados was talking about the cleanup going on that he witnessed at Warnaco Park, I received an email today from my daughter's Girl Scout troop, and she'll be participating at the Rahway River cleanup with her Girl Scout troop. And we have many stewards who are taking good care of our parks and working with our county employees who do good work every day to make sure that the parks are in good condition, the county facilities are in good condition, and that the services that the residents depend on are available. And that is all made possible, of course, through a responsible county budget. And while no one likes to see any sort of increase in taxes, I think the 1.75 increase is a responsible increase, and it speaks to our ability to continue to offer those services while continuing to offer a robust road resurfacing program, while continuing to offer a wide and varied selection of recreation opportunities and parks in this community. And I know the county manager, I know Director Taylor, and all the directors will be taking a fine pencil to their capital budgets this year to make sure that they are also responsible. And I know through many of the various cost-saving initiatives that are being put in place, from the reduction with juvenile corrections this year and more, that we'll see further savings in the future. So this is a very positive step, and I know we have a strong bond rating here in Union County, as well as ample resources, because we are in a good economic time, and history has taught us that death does not last forever. So it's best to be prepared so we can weather those tough times that might come ahead. But I think that the fiscal committee should be proud of this budget. Well done, Vice Chairman. Well done to your committee. And well done to the county manager and his staff, and Director Taylor and her staff for getting this together, as well as every employee who works in Union County, because I think we have a tremendous amount of service offerings that really speak to the far corners of this county. And so it's something we can stand behind and be proud of. Thank you, Chair.
Thank you, Freeholder. Vice Chairman Mirabella?
Yes, thank you, Madam Chair. April is Autism Awareness Month, and with that in mind, I'd like to draw your attention to some upcoming recreational activities coordinated through our Office for Persons with Disabilities and Special Needs. There's basketball, soccer, and golf outing scheduled in April. Also, if you're planning to visit our annual Touch a Truck event in the Watchung Reservation on April 28th, there will be a sensory-friendly hour from 11 to noon, so take advantage of that. And while you're up there, take a look at the sensory-friendly trail that was there. I know Director Zuber is very proud of that, received an honor, a national honor at a recreation conference he went to for that trail, and we're proud of that, and I think a lot of residents are taking advantage of that. The sensory-friendly theater continues as Freeholder Williams talked about, the Union County Performing Arts Center on April 28th, there'll be a performance of Henry and Mudge. On a different note, we're all looking forward to our third annual Union County Pride Celebration, organized through our Office of LGBTQ Affairs and coordinated with Pride Month in June. This year, we'll return to Rahway River Park in Rahway for an inclusive afternoon of family games, crafts, and entertainments on June 15th. For more information on all our recreational programs, and get in touch with the Office of Persons with Disabilities and Special Needs or the Office of LGBTQ Affairs, please visit the county website at ucnj.org. Earlier today, I had the good fortune to attend a conference called Equality in the Workplace, hosted and presented by Garden State Equality, great partners of this county and great state representatives for the LGBTQ community. The Deputy County Manager, Deputy County Manager Wagner, and our coordinator of LGBTQ office, Newberry, attended, and I thought it was an outstanding conference with a real, as it's interesting that Freeholder Williams talked about the transgender community. There was a whole section in this curriculum today on the transgender community, and I thought that was the highlight for me because I needed more information on it. It was terrific. Just earlier tonight, I also had the opportunity to listen in on the Union County College Board of School Estimate. I'm not a member of that. That's for other freeholders to participate, if Freeholder Williams, the chair, and Freeholder Estrada. But I did want to mention that I always am impressed with the students that Dr. McMenamin brings out. She's deliberate in her kind of a representative sample of the students who attend Union County College. And I think it's always great to sit there and see the impact that this board makes on college students who have decided that a junior college or a county college is a good start for them. And wherever we heard some students applying to some terrific universities and colleges after their 2 years and they get their associates. So we're proud of our commitment, continued commitment to Union County College, and it's the work that they're doing is just outstanding. And Madam Chair, that concludes my comments.
Thank you. And Freeholder Staden?
Thank you, Madam Chair. Thank you, everyone, for coming out this evening. I have a few announcements. The Office of Cultural and Heritage Affairs will conduct a free history grant writing workshop on Wednesday, April 17th, from 5 p.m. to 6 p.m. at the Reeves Reed Atrium, located at 165 Hobart Avenue in Summit. Those in attendance will learn how to apply for two types of history grants through the FY 2020 Union County History Re-Grant Program funded by the New Jersey Historical Commission. The grant application forms will also be available on site. This workshop is for writers of all skill levels, beginners, experienced, and in between. Cultural and Heritage Affairs has also launched registration for the 2019 Union County Senior Art Exhibit for adults 60 and older. Art that qualifies will be on display at the atrium of Liberty Hall Center at 1085 Morris Avenue in Union Township, and the artist will be honored with a reception at the atrium in June. For more information or to register online, please go to the Union County website, ucnj.org/senior-art-show. In closing, I'd like to give a huge congratulations to Debbie Ann Anderson for receiving an award this weekend at the Harambe Breakfast. Several freeholders were in attendance. Yes, I have the pleasure of working. Yes, Harambe. I have the pleasure of working with Debbie on several boards. She manages the largest budget in the county, and it's a well-deserved award. So thank you for all your hard work, Debbie Ann. And I think that's it. That concludes my comments this evening. Thank you.
Thank you, Freeholder Estrada.
Thank you, Madam Chair. A couple of things. I had the opportunity on Saturday, March 23rd, to attend Union County College between 1 and 3:30 at an event that was sponsored by Census 2020, Union County College, Lupe, which is a Hispanic women's group, OFA and TAL, which are two other groups that are made up from Union County College, to talk about Census 2020. Also, I was joined by Phil Candle, who works with the Department of Economic Development, who is our count, Census 2020 counter. And I sincerely mean that because his job has so diversified at this time, and very simply because the federal government is not really putting all the money they should into this project. Also, Natalie Hernandez from the Community Development Affairs Director in trying to get greater number of the community involved. What we're finding, and there were people from the Census 2020 from the regional office of New York, which encompasses also Union County, the issue at hand is in the manner which the census will be conducted. This year, one of the things they're trying to do is to use more of an online process, which is fine for people who are really good at online, but overall, the critical aspect of why Census 2020 is so critical is, number one, is because it will decide how federal funds get distributed in our area, and that's something that's very important. It's something that people rely on, as well as a determining factor of the congressional districts, which will be then, after the census, reshaped or changed or what have you. One of the things that I think the biggest voice that came from the audience was the fact is that every effort should be made to ensure that we have enough enumerators, people who are knocking on doors, even though that is the final aspect of the overall project. I believe that their intention is to send out a notice to every address of record. And the problem is that sending a notice to address of records does not necessarily mean it's going to get to everyone, because as we all know, there are many individuals who may live at addresses that their names is not in the mailbox, or that the mere fact that they're sharing a home or an apartment with someone else who are not really their immediate family, which changes the scope how things, how people are counted. The people are counted by nucleus of families. So in other words, if you have a husband and wife and three kids, that's five people. And it doesn't include, it may include, for example, a grandmother or a grandfather, but if you're not related, then that necessarily is not part of the process. So it's a very interesting scenario. So I believe we made it very clear to the Census 2020 and the people in New York that they really needed to have a lot of boots on the ground in terms of assuring that that we count everyone. The biggest issue is that the federal government has really underfunded the intention of Census 2020. I don't know why. Maybe they don't think they need it, but the reality is that we will be challenged because it is in our best interest to ensure that all the people of Union County be counted. So it is my understanding that first something will go out in the mail, which people have a choice of either using through the internet to respond, or they can do it by phone. If those two options are not utilized, then that leaves a very large gap, which traditionally, for example, we looked at some census tracts in Elizabeth, and there was like a no-show of, that's a 2010 census, which was man-driven with a lot of people, some census tracts with 36% no-show. That means that they knew there was 36% more people than actually responded to their census data in 2010. So we really need to ensure that, I know that Phil Candle is doing a fantastic job, especially with the amount of development that has taken place in Union County across the board. If you look at how many apartments has been built just close to the rail lines, it's amazing. So the number of people, those were not in the original tracks that the census put together, because they're new addresses. So one of the things we're concerned about, if you look close to the county here, there's like almost 400 apartments being built by Elizabeth, in back of Union County College. and they're not completed yet. So therefore, those most likely are not part of those tracks. And I know that Phil is doing an outstanding job to ensure that all of these things get counted in. But this is not the first time, that the only time that I'll be talking about Census 2020. I think it's very important that that all the community groups get involved, that every aspect of our communities play a big role. That's why I was very happy to see Natalie Hernandez there, because I know she's also very much interested in making sure that, because all the funding that people get, education, welfare, and everything else, it's predicated on the numbers of people that live in your area. So Union County College played a very key role, and I think there's a big commitment from the college to move forward in the future to ensure that everybody is counted. I think I've exceeded my time. I may have taken 1 minute credit from my bank time. Thank you very much.
Freeholder, we won't hold it against you. Freeholder Palmieri Mudd.
Thank you, Chair. Sorry.
We'll count you in.
I'd like to start by just mentioning that I had the honor last week of attending the CASA Women's Leadership Luncheon and presenting three outstanding women in Union County with resolutions for all of the hard work that they've been putting into our community, in particular the children of CASA. And it's really a fantastic organization doing great things for the most vulnerable of our community. So I wanted to just once again recognize them. I'd also like to thank our county manager, deputy county manager, and directors for your presentations during our budget hearings. As a new freeholder, it was really helpful for me to have those thorough explanations of each department. So I thank you for that. And lastly, there's so many people within our community that are environmental heroes, and we do have an open award process that nominations are due on Friday, April 12th. you can check out the ucnj.org/trailside for that application. But I encourage everyone in the county to think about the people in their communities that are making a difference to keep our environment healthy and move forward with those efforts and apply for that award. So thank you. Thank you, Chair.
Thank you, Freeholder. County Council?
No comments, Madam Chair. Thank you.
County Manager?
Thank you, Chairman. On behalf of Freeholders Hudak, Mirabella, Granados, I just want to congratulate the Mets on their big opening day.
Thank yes, thank you, County Manager.
Out of work, Graziana.
All right, thanks for adding that.
Important stuff.
Yeah, okay. I have a few comments. Once again, a shout out to Board of Elections Administrator Dorado on the good job with getting out the machines, voting machines for demonstration, the Express Vote XL. These showings of the new voting machines are continuing, voters and non-voters, because children under 18 are interested in them too, and they'll be voting one day. There'll be staff on hand at each session to provide guidance. They're open on a walk-in basis. And these are the first new voting machines that we've had in 20 years. And of course, represent a significant investment in the election infrastructure of Union County. So you can find the full schedule of when you can try out one of these voting machines on the county website. And thanks again to Administrator Dorado and all of your staff. We've had a busy couple of weeks. I want to thank all of the people and the Raritan Valley Rail Coalition, Chair Bruce Bergen, and all the people who made possible the forum that we had on Tuesday, the 26th. As part of Freeholder Initiatives, we have talked about promoting transportation throughout the county and, of course, working with the Raritan Valley Rail Coalition, and this particular forum was about the Gateway Tunnel, and we had Jerry Zarro, the chairman of the Gateway Development Corporation, speaking. It was a very successful meeting at the Cranford Community Center, standing room only. Dozens of people from all across the state, because Raritan Valley Rail serves Union, Middlesex, Hunterdon, and Somerset counties, and people from all those counties signed the petition for the one-seat ride for direct service without changing in Newark into New York. Former Freeholder Bruce Bergen noted the coalition's work with Senator Scutari to draft legislation aimed at helping to bring about a full-time one-seat ride. And legislation is now in the State Senate Transportation Committee for discussion. We'll keep you posted on that, or you can follow us on our webpage and social media. And of course, the coalition is always looking for volunteers to join us in the fight for better rail service. So if you would like more information, please email the coalition at raritanvalleyrail.com. Also, our public information director, Seb D'Elia, is available to answer questions, and he's at sdelia@ucnj.org. So the webpage is raritanvalleyrailcoalition.com. We had our newest congressional representative, Tom Malinowski, visit Union County at the college week before last. And thanks to Dr. McMenamin and the college staff for hosting that. Representative Malinowski is an excellent choice for this congressional district. He answered every question very reasonably. He talked about supporting the SALT deductions. He talked about transportation. He's for the Gateway Project. He is for human rights, that was another very very well-attended meeting, and of course I thank Representative Malinowski for coming, and I'm sure it won't be the last time we'll be seeing him in this area. This Friday, we have our Women of Excellence Award celebration, our 27th annual celebration, and it will be at Grand Centurions in Clark, starting at 6 o'clock. I'm not sure if it's sold out, but if you are interested in attending, you can go to the county website and contact the Commission on the Status of Women about attending that. And I unfortunately, because of illness, was not able to be there, but I understand the St. Patrick's Day Parade was fabulous. Sister Percy Lee brought, 15 buses full of, no, not 15, maybe 40 or 50 buses full of people? Yeah. Yes.
It had to be the whole school.
The entire, probably the entire school. Well, I wouldn't, Sister Percy Lee is a force to be reckoned with, and Union Catholic is also a very, it's a credit to the county, and its students turned out in force. I also want to thank all of the people who volunteered to help with Teen Arts. Teen Arts was another great celebration of the arts, also at the college. Let me just acknowledge Jamie Siegel here for the great work you've been doing in making sure that we can communicate all of the needs that various county groups have, and making sure that the college meets whatever we're able to coordinate. And Dr. McMenamin was here earlier with students, as Vice Chair Mirabella mentioned. So it's wonderful to see the high level of students attending Union County College, and we're very proud to be able to support. And thanks to Troop 75 Eagle Scout Keegan Martin of Cranford for work that he did on the arbor at Trailside Nature Center. And thanks, of course, to all the, to the county manager, deputy county manager, Director Taylor, and all the directors and staff for the work on the budget. I second the comments that have been made about how proud we are to continue to serve the county and at a cost as close to what we can afford as possible. And I think the 1.75 increase is a great credit to everyone. I think that is it for tonight. So I'm going to call for a motion to adjourn. So all in favor?
Aye.
Yes.
Thank you. We're adjourned.
Good job.